Fred, can you talk about as a coach, you're supposed to find something to worry about and something to look at film after this game. Is you're going to have a tough time finding blemishes and
rebounding. I mean, that was the thing that really kept them around in that first half. We could have got the ball off the glass and pushed it down in transition. I think we really could have stretched it even more in that first half. But I'm really proud of these guys for the way they approached it. You have a one-day prep on a team that runs a lot of different actions, and you really have to have great awareness to Pledger, to Osby, to Mbai, to Fitzgerald. I mean, all those guys come off with a lot of great actions, a lot of misdirection-type plays, and you really got to be on your toes. And for us to put in the game plan in 1.5 days and for the guys to go out and execute it the way that we did, I thought was outstanding. And I give our guys a lot of credit. After bouncing back after a huge win against Baylor, where we didn't shoot the ball great, and the preparation that we had in practice yesterday and the shoot around today certainly carried over into the game.
Everybody's going to focus on the shooting, particularly as hot as you guys were in the first half. But you just mentioned it, the defense was really, really pretty outstanding the entire game.
Yeah, I think 10 of their first 17 were second chance points. We were guarding the initial actions very well. Our stunts and rotations, like Chris Babb said, were off the charts tonight. There's one where Tyrus was a half second late, his hero should have shot, but other than that, I think in the first half we couldn't have played any better as far as our game plan is concerned. Now it's just a matter of taking care of that glass each and every night. We did a great job, I thought, against Baylor, a very long team, and we out rebounded. So that is something that we need to carry over if we're going to have a chance to win at Kansas State next Saturday.
I think Osby and Pledger combined for just 11. What did you guys do successfully to kind of slow them?
Well, Chris does such a good job chasing players. He did the same thing with Magruder. Before Magruder's baskets were runouts, and one was on a switch. He did a great job chasing him. That's the type of defender that Will is. Chris Babb is. He does such a good job of chasing those guys and being physical with them, getting into their bodies. He's got great feet. It's not just Chris. It's guys, as that pass goes, all the short sprint, they sprint and stunt the ball. Make those guys think before they rise up and shoot. And then just our awareness to Osby, we really wanted to shrink the floor when he got the ball. That kid put up a performance against Texas that was as good as any performance in the league this year. We scored 29 on him. So we had to have great awareness to him. And then Fitzgerald put 27 on us in Norman last year. So those guys have players that really play to their strengths. But I thought we did a good job trying to take that away. And I thought our ball pressure was much better tonight as well.
I think it was exactly a week ago you said that Percy and Anthony needed to get some confidence back, and they gave you some really big minutes tonight. Can you talk about what you saw from them?
Yeah, they gave us very important minutes. I think they had 6 blocks between the two of them at halftime. Percy really bodied up and stayed straight up and down on those shots. Then Booker, for not playing for a couple of games, I thought he had great mentality going in there and blocking shots that looked like baskets. And that was huge. We extended the lead. When those guys were in the game, and when you can do that with your bench, and give those guys credit. We shortened the rotation, they stayed positive, they continued to work, and I thought they took advantage of their minutes.
What does it say about Melvin? Picks up his third foul, he has to stay in for about 4 seconds straight, and they get into
it's one of those things. He picked up his second in the first, and then he got that third pretty quickly there in the second. Made a decision to keep him in there, and it worked out great. It's risky. Melvin picks up his fourth in that situation. You're kicking yourself. But I was confident that he would stay out of that foul trouble, and he did that for the next 7 or 8 minutes until he picked up his fourth in the 10-minute mark. But yeah, Melvin was great. It was good to see him back in there for extended periods. And Melvin's, I think, the most tenacious rebounder in the league.
Do you have another day and a half to prepare? Do you condense the game plan, or do you still throw about the same amount of stuff?
We didn't put quite as much out there as we normally do. We really talked about tendencies. Just always be prepared to be screened. Stand straight up and down, you're going to get nailed by multiple screens. And we had a couple emergency switches that I thought were really good. So just the overall awareness was excellent tonight. And when we have each other's back like that, when all 5 guys are playing together on that defensive end, we can be a pretty good defensive team. practice at Hilton or shoot around today, and I thought we'd go out and shoot the ball well tonight. But, you know, I think we've shown that we're going to shoot them. And, you know, our guys have, for the most part, stepped up and made
it. Coach, this was a better all-around performance so far this season, offensively, defensively?
I think it was, yeah. I think we put everything together tonight, and, you know, certainly something we can build off of. You know, I thought we played very well, against Baylor for the most part, with the exception of not shooting the ball well. I thought we did a good job guarding them and slowing down Pierre Jackson, even though he made some terrific plays, and slowing down Isaiah Austin with Will Clyburn at 6'7". But yeah, when you put it all together and you shoot the ball like we did tonight, we're a pretty tough game to beat. Yeah, Corey was really good spraying the ball around. I thought he did a really good job early as they were trapping and really get out and aggressively show on ball screens. I think hit that roll man going to the rim, and that really opens up the perimeter. When those guys show like that those guards have to sit in, and that's what opens up those three-point shots. Corey, even though he only made two shots, he was the quarterback out there that was getting everybody else. Kind of like Royce last year, we played open, took one shot, and we made 15 threes, and a lot of that had to be points. I've been really pleased with Corey. I thought Boone gave us 3 minutes as well. I thought both those guys were excellent. Getting us into our set, really pushing the ball down in transition and making good, solid plays